Okay, yeah, I think it has started.
Yes.
Go ahead.
So I've sent you that question. So, you know, like I was really confused. I went on to read everything, like most of the things I've read. I've tried to read Ramana Maharshi. I've tried to read some of the Advaita Vedanta, some of the Upanishads. But you know what all those things was? I really got confused with myself because and people actually say, and that's correct, that you should not read anything without a guru. Because the way we are taught is we have a dissecting intelligence. So all those things created confusion with me, and especially for me living a normal life, because I used to do my meditation, or I had few ethical principles, and I was really happy with my life until unless these questions came. And that day you cleared my doubt that who am I is not a question, it's just an inquiry. Because what people like me have in mind is like, who am I is a question, then I should get an answer like the way we write in our exams. So that was really confusing for me, and like for that I've searched a lot. So I like to hear your perspective, sir, that what is enlightenment? Like we say enlightenment, is it something that happens suddenly or it happens gradually?
So the enlightenment is more of an understanding. Basically, what is enlightenment? If you see, it's just an English word, right? If you do not know how to drive a car, and if you are enlightened with the driving skills, then you know how to drive a car. That's all. Similarly, if you do not know about this body and you read about this and you're getting enlightened with the knowledge about this body, you become a doctor and you're able to now manage the functions in the body. So enlightenment is just a simple English word, is getting to know. That's all. Similarly, enlightenment is about getting to know about our own self. Our own self here means not about the body, it is more about the mind, psychological structure. So that's all. If you are able to understand and how it functions, that is all is enlightenment, actually. It's actually a very simple phenomenon. But unfortunately, a lot of people have may not be purposefully, but somehow they want to convey what they want to say, but the people have got confused because it's little tricky also. There is
Like,
something
and in the book, there's something mentioned in Hindu philosophy, we have something called as Sat Chit and Anand. But in the book, like Absolute Reality, it is mentioned that something beyond bliss. So, what is there beyond bliss? Is there something beyond bliss or bliss, and then we learn to live with it?
yeah. No, so books, I think, as you said, we cannot rely too much on those things as well. So the first best thing is, first we have to understand our own self, this whole system, the psychological system. We need to understand how it functions. And so this is what will be useful in our day-to-day life. Otherwise, all those, if you are talking about all those bliss and all that, it will all be imaginary. Now, then you will be getting into an imaginary journey. Somebody will say something, then you will have to assume. Then you'll be on that endless journey because it will be an imaginary goal. You will try to achieve that imaginary goal, so everything will be imaginary. So rather, what we suggest is, in this concept, it is to do with your daily day-to-day life. It is to do with our day-to-day emotions and thoughts, what we can see. The journey, it is always better to start with where we know, right? Where I know. From there, if you start a journey, then at least you will know,
Measure
you
it.
will Yeah, it will be a better one. Otherwise, if you keep an imaginary target somewhere, then you will not know where you are going. So that way, it is better for us to understand. And once you understand the system, then all these questions will get answered on its own.
And like I was reading book by Sri Bhagavat Maharaj, some of one of his disciple has written in that website. You have many books, so few of his disciples have written few books. So like someone was there. He only mentioned about like beyond bliss. There's one chapter. I'll just send you the screenshot after this. But your explanation is perfect. Like because we try to cling on to something that is imaginary, and we miss out on everything. Like you know, that was the mistake I did because I read that text. I got misinterpreted. I thought that the human life is against experiences. We should not experience anything, and there is something beyond bliss. So how do I find that out? And we are not contented with what we have. We try to go and search for something different.
Yeah, true. So that's why I was saying it'll all take you on an imaginary endless journey. So first of all, let us understand our day-to-day stuff, whatever we are dealing with today, whatever we are close to. First, if you understand that, then everything else you will be able to grasp that. So that is why we suggest that first you will understand what is this, how is this mind functioning, what are the functions of this mind, what is the role that we can play here, and what are the do's and don'ts. If you understand this itself, then you will be psychologically free from all your burdens and all the struggles and conflicts that are going on endlessly in our mind. So once you are free, then all your external activities, the external life activities, whether you want to study, whether you want to work, whether you want to teach, whether you want to do music, or whether you want to go to Himalayas and be a monk, whatever, that is up to our choice. There is nobody can say this is the right thing to do. That is up to us. But the problem is, once only when you are free here, then you will be able to understand and think properly and do whatever you want to do. So there is nothing wrong and right here in the external world as well. Of course, yeah, if you are hurting somebody, then you can say that's a wrong act or something. But again, it is all your choice. It is all because the society is made for our own convenience. All the rules and regulations are made up for our own convenience and comfort. We all have come to an agreement that this is how we are going to live, right? So it is our choice. So psychologically is what we need to understand, and that is how this concept helps. I think you have read those books already, right?
I think you are more clear than reading those books, like, because somewhere maybe the author, the style of putting, because those books I think are not written by Maharaj. Okay. They're written by some of his disciples.
Oh, okay.
I went to his website only, like, okay. The website, shribhagwat.org. We have. So you can download those books. So, but your way is really crystal clear. Like, I can understand them, because in those books, now you say they talk of some philosophy, then yours is simple, practical, and crystal clear.
Correct. Yeah, that's what we are trying.
And sometimes there is something. The word is just related, but we manipulate and put it in so many different ways. So we think that this is a different concept. Same like enlightenment. You were explaining. Correct. Is life just meant to be on our spiritual journey, or we are meant to do something? I was just reading, some say this is Maya, this is that, this is that. Like, few are there who are like, everyone has their own different views. So how do I take that?
Yeah. So again, these are all imaginary things, because of course they are true to some extent. I mean, they have some relevance. More important thing is about understanding our psychological system. That is the most important, because as I said, that is what we live with day in, day out. That is where you, every day you're traveling with your life, along with this psychological system. So this is what you need to understand first, because those are all will be confusing, and there will be so many interpretations. Everyone will interpret their own way. What is Maya means, then they'll have different explanations, different interpretations. So all these, you will get on a confused path only. So what I suggest is, all those are not needed. I mean, first, if you understand this, then after that, if you are interested, you can, if you still have questions, you can get on to that. But if you understand this itself, that itself is sufficient, more than sufficient for our...
So should I take it like that? That if I just understand myself, that's more than sufficient. I don't need to go on and cling to some philosophy to get myself enlightened or get better. Because what happened, I was really better or stable. I wanted to get more better. So that thirst or that greed, that disturbed me somehow.
Yeah, so that is natural.
You read different books, everyone has their own different view, and your mind contradicts.
Yeah, that is quite natural, no? Because something which is attractive, if you see something attractive, obviously you are getting attracted to that, and you're trying to grab that or achieve that. So that is natural. So that is not a problem. So have you read these books, actually, this concept? Have you understood this concept?
I read few chapters, tried to read, but I was really confused. So I didn't want it to get more confused.
Okay. So the whole, the core idea of the concept is, all the entire psychological system, which is made up of your thoughts, emotions, feelings, whatever you call, is not under our control. You cannot say after the second from the 2 minutes after now, I will only have this thought or this emotion. Fifth minute from now, I'll have this thought number two and emotion number two. And then 10th minute from now, I'll have that thought and emotion. Nobody can say that, right? it's even if I'm speaking to you now, suddenly I made some thought about my office or some thought about my movie, some movie may come across. I may get into that and get dragged into that, right? So these thoughts and emotions, even emotions, for example, I may say that I want to be always peaceful. I should not be stressful. I should not be frustrated. I should not be angry. I should not feel jealous. I should not feel sorrow. I may have so many such conditions. I may put so many such conditions, but mind is not going to listen to all that. The moment you see something which is not according to your expectation, immediately you will be frustrated. You will be sorrow or angry. Whatever, all those emotions will arise in you. So these are not under our control at all. But we people imagine that this is a problem to handle. It is actually not a problem to handle. I think as I explained to you the other day, all emotions and thoughts are momentary. It just comes and subsides. It arises and subsides.
Like waveform, something up,
yeah,
something down.
Something like that. It just arises and subsides every moment. Sometimes people say, I feel that stressful for a longer time and all. It is because they are trying to get rid of that. They are trying to somehow get rid of that and trying to work with that or trying to reject it. So it is because of that, it gets relives. They relive that moment again and again. Because, see, what is all this mind finally? It is all memory, right? You are thinking about something. So memory, this memory actually has only space for one thought at a given point of time. Though you may experience many thoughts, it may be a fraction of a second. It may be a very small fraction of a second. But at a given moment, you will be able to experience only one thought. So it's like there is a space for only one thought. Only one thought can come in. So once the next thought comes in, automatically the next thought passes this memory space. It's like a platform in the train, right? The train compartment passes yes. One by one. Similarly, thought comes one by one. So nothing is actually waiting for us to handle. Nothing is waiting for us to get rid of or push it out or, push it out. So you don't need to do anything. Every moment, if you think, for example, if you are thinking about taking a coffee, right? Immediately this thought will vanish. This moment, that thought will subside and you will be thinking about coffee. If you're drinking coffee, right? So the moment you're done with that, if you're coming to this meeting, then that thought about coffee will be gone and you are thinking about this. So there is only space for one thought. So the moment you think about something else, automatically it means that the previous thought has already passed, which means your anger, jealous or whatever, sorrow, etc. is passing every moment. The moment you think about getting rid of that anger itself, the anger is already gone actually. The anger emotion which came, which is gone. Only thing is it leaves a little after, there is an after effect, like how this earthquake and lightning and all, there is an after effect, right? It has an after effect in the body also. It may cause some vibration, some chemical changes, etc. But slowly if you get used to it, it will be faster and like how I can say the fan blade, right? If you go faster and faster, the blade itself will not be visible after some time beyond the speed, right? So similarly, nothing will be visible. Everything will pass. It is all momentary. It is because that suddenly, I don't know, in the IT language, if I have to say, all emotions are going to the recycle bin.
That's correct.
We think that I have to handle
recycling all those things. We are not
You are grabbing that and keeping it in an inbox again and trying to handle that, which means you are again going to relive that same moment, same anger, same sorrow again and again. You are reliving that 100 times, 1,000 times. So it gets extended for a longer time. So you feel that I'm angry, I'm frustrated for 3 days. I'm not able to get rid of frustration because you are holding it. Frustration is not holding you. We are holding the frustration and trying to correct it. Because of that, you're reliving that same moment again and again and trying to hold it for 3 days. So that's the problem. If you allow everything, if you give full freedom to all your thoughts and emotions, everything will be momentary. It is gone. By the moment you think about next thing, it is already gone. So you don't even have to handle your problems. This problem of thinking that I'm frustrated or I'm sorrow, I'm not peaceful, I feel restless, is all imaginary. We think that we have to handle, we take responsibility and then we start working on that. We start fighting against its existence. So the problem continues. If you accept it completely, then the problem is gone within a moment.
And sir, one more thing that was written in the book, like I've misinterpreted. Like, is our philosophy against experiences?
Are they what?
Are they against experiences?
No. So we are not against anything for that matter. it is only an understanding, right? Experiences means you're talking about a pleasant experience or a painful experience, right? It is only the understanding that is required. There is nothing, as I said, even the experience is not under our control. The moment you see something which is meeting your expectations, there will be a pleasant experience. And when you see something which is not meeting your expectation, there will be a painful experience, a sorrow or a frustration. So that is quite natural. And this is the mechanism of the mind. Mind is like a, I can say it's like a signal meter. So when there is something which you don't like, it produces a signal saying that a frustration, in the form of frustration or whatever. And if it is pleasant, it produces a pleasant signal. So you don't have to alter the signal. This is just an instrument which gives you the signal. It's just indicating what is happening in the real life, in the external world. So if you want to correct it, the correction is required in the external world. Not, you don't have to meddle with this signal meter, indicator. So it is like high voltage means it gives the high voltage. You cannot, there is no point in breaking this high voltage LED itself. That high voltage indicator bulb is not the problem, right? High voltage means you have to fix the high voltage there, the external activity. Not, you don't have to deal with the indicator and say, I should not get high voltage indicator at all. That is foolish, na?
So can we consider something like that we are comfortable with ourselves and whatever we do, we don't let it impact our own well-being, like inner well-being. Or we are not affected, like somehow if I fight or something, it's just externally. I don't keep it some grudges internally, or I just let go, thoughts pass and come. I don't put some conscious efforts in fighting with them. So is that okay?
Okay. So you are talking about an external action now, right?
Yes.
Whether to fight or not and all that. So
not about fight. Anything. Let's say anything. Like suppose we are talking or I'm working somewhere. So is that fine that I'm not into my psychological mess, and so that I can work freely, na?
Yeah. So whatever is, see, when you're saying work means you're working towards a goal, right? Working towards making something. So that is the goal there. So whatever is required, whatever efforts are required for that, achieving that goal. So that is what is, that effort is needed. Not about these mind and emotions. If you start thinking about these, then definitely, yeah, you will be caught up in this and you will start getting into a conflict with what is happening in your mind, in your experiences and all. So we don't have to worry about this whole system at all. Our focus should be entirely on the outside world.
There were so many texts, since I started searching even searching different philosophies of different religion. So I thought that, is that necessary to that I should read all those things to get enlightened?
No, you don't need to. So as such, as I explained, this is a simple concept. I think the most simple concept that you will find anywhere. So there is no practice. There is no practices or any kind of meditation or any exercises. Nothing of that is needed. A simple understanding of our system is sufficient. So that itself will free you from all your problems and botherings, and all the psychological burden will be gone with this.
So your first note is, I have to take care of my psychology. I just need to observe it and let go. Don't get attached with all those things.
Okay. Not observe it. Maybe you can go through the book. I'll suggest, I think there is a book called Don't Delay Enlightenment, or How to Get Rid of Your Worries. I think Smash Your Sorrows or something. So those are the books that you can read.
By Maharaj only. Same form.
By Bhagavad, only. So he is, so that books you can read, because it will talk about the concept only. It will only talk about the concept. So the concept here is, you don't have to deal with it also. Because even if you try to deal with it, it is not under your control. Like, it is like saying, I want to decide the Prime Minister of India. You don't have to break your head about that, right? Because it is not under your control. So similarly, the psychological system is not under our control. So this is not to be taken as an instruction or as a concept. It is for you to research and understand. You have to experiment inside your own system, and you have to come to that conclusion that this psychological system is not under my control. If you come to that conclusion, then you will drop all your efforts to correct it, to fine tune it, to make it something better. So seeking for perfection will drop, because anyway you don't have control, right? Why will I think about something? Why will I worry and break my head about something which is not under my control? So that is the conclusion that you have to come to, not just listen to what I'm saying, and you should not come to that conclusion based on that. You should research, you should see whether really is the system really under my control. Because every moment you're facing a lot of emotions and thoughts, right? Is it really under your control? You can think about it and then you have to conclude that conclusion. And once for all, you have to come to that conclusion. And once you drop your efforts to make it better, make the system better, then all your efforts, you will be psychologically free. Then you can focus your efforts on whatever you want to do outside.
I misinterpreted like something that something from outside will come since I am imperfect and something outside will come and make it perfect for me. And I was not working on myself and looking inside me. Like, you know, like somehow I got misinterpreted that you can't experience by yourself. Something is needed or some form of...
Yeah, and also another thing is, as you said, you don't have to observe every moment and see how it is and all. Nothing of that sort is needed. So it is like once you are only during the experiment, when you want to experiment and test it out, you can observe, you can do all that. But finally, once you come to the conclusion that the system is not under my control, then that's all. You have to just put a door and seal this door completely because there is nothing to do here. So you don't have to observe, you don't have to monitor, you don't have to track how your mind is behaving. Nothing is needed. You can close this door completely. Your entire focus can be on the external activities. So you'll be completely free from all these.
Yes, because only if you try to improve yourself like that and you find all the imperfections. And one more thing, like in the same book, like this one book written by Absolute Reality, I think.
Yeah. Okay.
So what I was telling that Beyond Bliss was there. So I don't know whether it was just a title or something, but I think bliss is the ultimate, which we all seek as a human.
Yeah, bliss again is more of an egoistic approach, right? Bliss, there is a person who wants to see, as I think the other day I explained, right? From the childhood, there are different various levels of desire. Initially, when we were a child, we were looking for an ice cream, chocolate. Then
and you told that desire is good because you can get fulfilled with that.
It is the same desire which is manipulating in various, which is evolving in various ways. That's all. There's nothing great about bliss also. The seeking of bliss and seeking drunkard going to get drunk is the same. Right? You're looking for happiness. That's all. Nah? You're just giving it a different name. You want happiness. That's all you're saying. You feel that by achieving that bliss, you will feel happy and satisfied. Same way somebody is feeling that by drinking, he will feel satisfied and happy.
So like, okay. And one more thing, like how can we make ourselves better human beings? Like we are always surrounded by our society, our family. So yeah. I think only when we take our conscious responsibilities, then only we can do some change for ourselves and others.
So this responsibility and making a better life is more on the external side. Psychologically, there is nothing called good and bad. Because every thought is momentary. Even the worst thought is going to just vanish within a fraction of a second. The worst emotion is going to vanish within a fraction of a second. We don't have to worry about the system at all. If you simply allow and take back, just rest back and sit back, enjoy, then this will go perfectly fine. All your action is going to be on the external world. In the external world, you can consider it as good action and bad action, living a better life. All that is, again, it depends on your philosophy. You may say that feeding to the poor, better living. Or I will say doing something else, maybe doing the spiritual sessions is a better living. It is up to you. That you can make your choice. Whatever you want to do in the external life, it's up to you.
And so the lectures which you conduct, how often do you conduct those lectures?
So we have a team of people, not just me, team of people, and we almost do a session every day, but most of it is in Tamil. So very few sessions are in English. So
you have a center in Canada also, no?
Center means we have some people, across. Yeah, we have some people in US, Canada.
So they might be having those sessions in Tamil only or English also?
No, nobody has. I mean, all of them are, as of now, most of them, we are from India only, conducting sessions from India only, most of them. Yeah. But sometimes, they may also do that. But very less English sessions, because even I was actually conducting few English sessions, but very few participants, they didn't have questions. So then we converted that into Tamil. So, but if there is a specific request, then we can
And is it based on teaching, or we deal with questions in the sessions, like someone has spiritual doubts or something?
Yeah, in the sessions, we will, as I just explained to you, I probably give an overview. If there are newcomers, new participants, then I'll just give an overview, 5 minutes brief of what we are talking about. Then they can come up with questions. Mostly it is people who have already read. They will only have a lot of questions, right? It is mostly, it will be useful more for them than the
people. Because they are the more inquisitive people, and they doubt everything. Like those who read more. Because
That is one. And also this is not like a question and answer. Like I tell you immediately, you will not be able to accept, right? You
have to ponder about it. Evolve
in life. You have to ponder about it. You have to think about it. It is your idea and your opinion about this concept is very, very, very important than what I say. Because finally, it has to work in your system, right? It is not just because I say drop all your efforts, you will not be able to drop your efforts.
I'm so relaxed after talking with you, because 2 months back, I read this book and I was just scrolling it, and something was wrong. Like I didn't understand about experience. So I thought, okay, all my experiences are bad. I should not do this. I should not do this. Okay. I should not think. I should not. Okay. Like somewhere I thought, is it something coming out from something from outside body? And then you told that you should look within, like you're free. Like there's nothing, like just your thoughts. You let it go. So I hope I'm right. Like my understanding is okay now.
Yeah, so understanding, as I said, is a psychological freedom. And the psychological freedom is already existing. There is nothing to achieve or nothing new that is going to you're going to achieve or obtain. It is simply an understanding is sufficient, because all the while we were creating the disturbance in the system, psychological system. We were making this disturbance. All your chaos and confusion and frustration, we were creating. Because we think that I have to take responsibility. The moment a thought comes, we think I have to take responsibility, grab it and try to work on it and make a mess out of it. So once you understand that it is already running perfect, if you simply take your hand off, it is already running perfect. If you understand, then the psychological disturbance is gone. You are completely peaceful and free. And all this mess is gone. So that is what we are trying to arrive at. It is like if you take a bowl of water and if you put your hand inside, it will create some waves and ripples, right? Right. So those are your emotions, your thoughts, whatever you can call. So how do you get rid of these emotions now? How can we get rid of these emotions?
Nothing. Just let it go. Nothing.
Correct. If you try to do something in the name, whatever name you give, by means of practice or meditation or by means of inquiry, by means of acting on observing, monitoring, whatever name you give, if you try to put your hand in that, it is only going to create more chaos. You cannot get rid of these waves by doing something, by acting against it. Only by taking step off, taking your pedal, taking your foot from the pedal, just stepping back, it's going to settle within few minutes, few seconds. So that is the same functionality. That is how mind functions. So if you simply step back, everything is going to be perfect. But we have to come to this conclusion. You have to understand this, how this is how it functions. And you have to come to that conclusion. Not just because I'm saying, then it's
no, like now after that, you are saying, I'm trying to understand something, because after that confusion, I read. So even anyone used to speak and I thought, okay, no, this is the doubt. I must get it cleared. And someone from his family, like, that really makes sense. And you told about that simple enlightenment. And you know, ultimately, even if you read thousands of books, ultimately you need to come to yourself only.
Correct. Yes, exactly. Those books, finally, you're reading it to create some kind of happiness or peace, whatever name. So all this enlightenment is what? Finally, I want to be peaceful. I want to be happy. That's the final ultimate thing everybody asks in the name of various things. Somebody asks for in the name of enlightenment, somebody searching in the name of money, somebody searching in the name of power, politics, all. Finally, everybody wants to be happy and peaceful, fulfilled. That's the word.
We are not against any form of enjoyment in life.
Yeah. There is nothing wrong. It is completely, once you know the system, it is like, see, once you know how the car functions, you will not end up in, you know, in an accident. You will not press some buttons and instead of accelerator, if you press brake and all these functions, if you understand correctly, then you can go on your own journey. However fast you may want to go, it is up to you all. If you want to slow down your car, take a rest, park your car and maybe there is a beach. Relax some for 2 days and then go on your journey. That is all completely up to you. The problem is we do not know how to drive this car, this system, then we end up in messing something. You get up in an accident. You end up in hitting somebody. You end up in, you know, your car getting repaired and you getting into an accident, all that. So that is the problem. So now if you understand, now you know how to drive a car, then it is up to you. It is, there is no mandatory, there is no, nobody forcing that you have to drive a car at 100 kilometer only, or you have to keep park your car and you should not drive. There is nothing like that. It is completely up to you.
Yes. That makes so much of sense to me. And now I think I'll take charge of myself, because really you told me, because you know, I was so much hallucinating that something external, or not even, if something would have been, I would have been dependent on, then it would have, I would have been happy that I would have told someone that, okay, I'll be dependent on you. But you told me that you should be dependent from inside, so within yourself. And that is the best thing that I can hear. And I think this is a simple enlightenment for me.
Correct.
And I won't read anything. And you know, once you start reading everything, now you doubt yourself only.
Okay. So that is fine. Even this doubt is going to help you only. No problem. I mean, just to be more clear or more convinced, for that purpose, you can read it, you know, 2-3 times. If you read it, then you will be able to get a better idea. Because you'll be more, the important point is you have to ponder about it. You have to think about it. You have to see, you know, okay, what am I thinking about it? Is it really fitting what I'm thinking? Am I looking for this? So those kind of interactions that you should do within yourself. Not just because I'm saying, you don't have to accept. I may be lying also, no? Why do you have to believe me? So that way, I'm saying, once you are...
Experiment by own self.
Huh? Yeah. If once you understand your own self, then there is no... You don't need to ask anybody. The entire thing will be clear to you.
Yes. That's so clear. So, you know, whenever you have English sessions...
Yeah.
And if I can come, so you can... Sure. I'd be honored to come and join.
Yeah. Sure, no problem. And you can also, whenever, if you have any question, follow-up questions, just put it in. We will respond. That's not a problem.
Sure. So, you are in Chennai, na?
Yes.
Okay. And what about Maharaj? Is he still teaching or he's not teaching now?
No, he is. He is aged now, but he is now conducting sessions every week. He is also conducting sessions, mostly in Tamil.
But, yeah. Okay. So, he's just preaching the simple philosophy for life.
Yeah. So this actually, there is no, in fact, if you see, there is no master, guru, Sishya relationship and all here. Everybody is a master. Once you understand, you are also a master only now. If you understand and if you're able to drop your efforts, so that is called as enlightenment. Once you understand, you can also pass this knowledge to anybody in your own words, in your own simple language, in your own terms. It is actually, you don't need to connect this with the spirituality at all. Spirituality, religion, this philosophy, all these. No, all great words. You don't have to connect. You don't have to connect this with all these things. It is simple understanding of your psychological system. That's all. Mm-hmm. It's a scientific process. It is not something which is a which you have to believe and understand and someday you will reach. No, it is a scientific process. If you throw a ball up, it is going to fall down, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it is correct. A new gravitational force. Similarly, mm-hmm. this mind is working on. It's a scientific process, scientific phenomenon. Nobody needs to, you don't need any religion or spirituality for this. There is no connection at all. It is a simple scientific understanding. Anybody can understand this and be freed from all psychological problems.
Just
all
understand psychological one thing, that don't put any efforts. Leave your efforts and you'll be like that.
Correct. But they have to be convinced. That is the problem. They may not be convinced. They will think that no, what you're saying may not be true. And, you know, yeah, we have to chase that. I have read in that book, somebody, Vivekananda is saying this and Ramana Maharishi is saying that. Ramakrishna is saying this, they will keep on searching for those perfection. They will have an idea of a perfection. They will
perfection
think that
you never try to reach them because you are trying to be something or your goal is something.
Because they will have some imaginary idea about enlightenment. They will think that once I enlighten, all some power will come inside me. I'll know everything past, your past, future, everything I'll be able to predict and I'll be able to move objects and something.
Same happened with me. Like I had some idea that I'll be sitting, some light will be coming. And you know, the Buddha, all, photo of Buddha.
Right. Like, all people, there will be hundreds of people gathered around me asking about these topics and all that. Nothing of that sort is.
So correct.
Yeah.
So correct.
Because it is that teaching is more of a, teaching is an art. You are able to, if you're able to deliver the message in a beautiful, simple way, which is understandable way, then people will gather. An enlightened person need not be a good teacher, need not be a good speaker. I can just be enlightened with myself. I can be simply happy with myself. I need not be a good communicator also. So I may not be able to simply able to communicate the message in a simple manner. So people may not understand, and people may not stay with me. So that is not the necessary. It is just an art of communicating is different from your enlightenment. If there is a marketing, people in the marketing and sales field, they may be a better communicator than me.
Mm-hmm.
If they understand this concept, somebody who can speak better, they may be able to communicate and give the message, broadcast this message in a much better way.
Mm-hmm.
Just because I understood, but maybe they have not understood. That's the only difference.
That's correct. Yeah. You are associated since how many years, sir?
About 10 plus years now.
Okay. Yeah. So someone introduced you, or was it your interest to know?
I mean, I was searching. I started with Ramakrishna, Vivekananda, then Ramana Maharishi, Osho. Osho was my favorite. So all those books, and did all those meditations.
You're like me only.
So all those meditation, all that I did, and I didn't achieve anything. I was searching for long, for 10 years, 15 years types.
I am imperfect, or something is wrong with me.
That is true, na? Because when you are not, somebody is saying you have to meditate and achieve this, and you are not able to achieve this, you will always be feeling guilty about, maybe I'm not the right person, I'm not able to do meditation, I'm not able to reach that blissful state. So all those things were coming. So once I suddenly got this book somehow, I read this, and it was totally different. It was saying something different. Then I drilled down, slowly started researching, and is he really saying true? Because I don't believe anybody, even. That I'm not a God believer also. I'm a rationalist. I don't just like that. If somebody says Guru, I don't want to. Why should I believe you? You are saying something. I want to test it out. I want science. I want rational, logical test is what, that's how I'm, my mindset is. So I started testing this concept. I started checking, is my mind really under my control? I was not able to accept initially. How can I, I'm only creating, I'm only, responsible for these, my thoughts. For all these thoughts and thinking, everything. But then slowly, once I started researching and understanding this concept, then finally I understood that yes, all these things are happening naturally. It is not under my control. Like a heartbeat or a liver is functioning inside our body, this mind is also a function which is happening inside my body. Yeah, I don't have to be worried about what happens inside. Only thing is, this mind is a tool which is required for your external action. Suppose if you want to go to somewhere, if you want to travel somewhere, you have to use mind and think and plan, right? How to go, where to go, what time I should travel, whether I should travel by air or rail, etc. So that is the that is the tool. You can use your mind for all these all positive, creative things. Whatever you want to do outside, for that purpose, you can use your mind as a tool. Mm-hmm. But mind itself need not be perfect. You don't have to perfect the mind itself. Psychologically, you don't have to keep it perfect. But for external activities, you can use this mind as a tool. Like how you use your computer, Google, for if you want to go somewhere, you're Googling and using it for your as a tool, right?
So
that way you can use this
I mind. I thought that I'm imperfect, and once I get enlightenment, I'll be happy with myself or something.
Huh.
But your philosophy is really simple, that you are happy. Nothing is there, because if you chase something, you'll be unhappy. Like with the failures of not getting. And one more thing I want to ask you, since we have followed Ramana Maharshi Maharaj, his famous question, who am I? Is it an inquiry or yes?
Yeah. So as I said, the objective of that question is to dissolve the questioner, is to vanish the questioner itself. That is the whole objective of that question. Because if you keep on questioning that again and again and again, at the end of it, you will understand that you are the question itself. So it is some concept. Basically, see, even this I also, for example, if you see at a high level, this concept of I. So what is I? What is the difference between you and me? Forget about the physical body differences. What do you think is the difference between you and me?
Nothing. You are the same life as I am.
But your ideas, opinions, your concepts, you must be having something in your mind.
Yes, prejudices.
I may be having some concepts, ideas, something about in my mind, right? So that's the only difference, right? Between you and me, that's the only thing which differentiates, right?
Yes, yes.
And what are these ideas, concepts? It is all borrowed from the society or something, right?
Mm-hmm.
From the external life. And these ideas and concepts are also momentary. It is not going to stay away with you permanently. I mean, there is nothing holding you. This is again a thought, right? It is also momentary. Every moment it is flowing. Every moment it subsides. So only if you are holding it willfully, then only you will be holding to it. Otherwise, that is also passed away. So even this concept of I, this feeling of I is also part of that, these ideas and thoughts.
Same thing.
So I will also flow. So I also will flow along with that. You know, if you don't hold it, if you're not holding it, if you're not adamant about anything, right? If I'm adamant about something, I want to do only this way, then only you will be holding that concept. And as part of that concept, you will be holding your I. That I also you're holding. If you are completely flexible, if you are flowing with how it flows psychologically, then even this I will flow. There will be no identity at all. Mm-hmm. I also will keep flowing. So I will get dissolved. So like I said, the example of a fan blade, only if you keep watching very closely, if it moves very slowly, the blades will be visible. Mm-hmm. Once it goes, once you give full freedom and the fan, you know, fan rotates very fast speed, like, what I mean is, if it is very slow, means you are not giving freedom to that rotation, that flow of your thoughts. You are actually disturbing that flow. If you give full freedom, then it goes really fast. It just flows very fast, like this fan rotation. Then this blade itself will not be visible. Similarly, even I will not be visible. Almost like I will be getting dissolved, or it will be like very visible in a very weak form. So it is for this stage only, the same question of who am I is applied in the same context only. So finally, you will reach this state of your I itself, the questioner, the person who questions who am I, will also get dissolved in that question.
Because once you leave all the questions, it's the psychological mess.
Correct.
Even question arises from inside.
Correct. That is the purpose of that experiment, that inquiry of who am I.
I thought that I'll get some answers like written in a sheet or something.
That's not going to help. It's not a science or max, right?
So it's so good to talk to you, sir. And thank you very much for clearing on my confusions.
Okay.
And I'll get back to you if I have some questions. I'll just send you and we'll look at it. And thank you very much, sir.
Okay, no problem.
So we'll end our meeting here, but we'll stay in touch with.